Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Southern California. It's a beautiful, overcast day that we engage with that because we get so many days of sunshine here each year that when we get an overcast day, it's almost like being up in Seattle or back in the Midwest when you guys get a lot of rain and, you know, a lot of snow and things like that. So it's kind of a wonderful change for us, as I would like to say. This is the first book, The Barbecue Joe Chronicles, but from the second book, we are doing Gagmeanna's Raspberry Pork Loins. Now, Gagmeanna's Raspberry Pork Loins are based on one of the characters, and the raspberry happens to be part of the story. So that if you want to download the digital copy of the Kindle Read book, not the soft copy like this, but the Kindle version, you can download it to your computer, your iPad, your iPhone, or your Droid, and even your Blackberry now, apparently. There's a lot of great information in this historical piece. You know, this is a real serious document. Don't take me too serious, folks. Let's talk about what we're doing. All right, so Gagmeanna Raspberry Pork Loins. Now, these things have been marinating for a day in bourbon, as you can see here. And they smell absolutely phenomenal. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you how we make, okay, Gagmeanna's Raspberry Pork Loins, Gagmeanna's Raspberry Glaze. We take 1 cup of raspberries. Raspberries are really good for you, so you should really try to eat some. And basically just pulverize them, just like that. And as they're pulverized, now I do it while they're dry so they don't shoot up everywhere. And then I add in some maple syrup. And we just go like that. Now remember, this is just a glaze. Now we're gonna use, tonight we're gonna use an apple chunk to actually smoke it. These are purely a very sweet meat, which is what pork is anyway. It's the other white meat, as they call it. And so we're just basically gonna make this a really sweet delight. Okay, now, oh my God, just with the maple syrup in it, you can't even believe how amazing that is. Now, basically 1 shot. Just mix it around. 1 shot of that Jack Daniels, or this is Evan Williams, but it doesn't really matter because save the good stuff for when you're having a shot or if you're making a bourbon and coke. This glaze is amaze. So you won't even believe it when you actually try this. This going on top will go on in the last 10 minutes. It'll caramelize. We'll have it up around 350 degrees the entire time. We're gonna slow cook it. So it takes almost an hour to do these things. And then at the very last 10 minutes or so, that's when we put this glaze on. And the glaze will caramelize and it will be absolutely delicious. There's a lot of sugar in this because of the raspberries and because of the maple syrup. So we don't want to put it on till the very end because we don't want it to come off scorched. We just want it to caramelize, and we want it to have kind of a almost caramelized kind of consistency to it at the end. For the wine tonight, we're going to do a Behringer Pinot Noir. Now, if this had some spice in it, this is going to be a very sweet tasting pork loin. And because it's going to be purely sweet with no salt, no pepper, no Greek seasoning, none of that, we're going to go with something a little bit lighter that's going to pair nicely with this. I would go with a Syrah if this was actually Jiku's oink oink pork loins, blue ball pork loins. Because we do use the Greek seasoning, I put a little bit of garlic powder in it, and it really has a lot of stuff going on. This is very primally simple. We will see you grill side here in several hours. That we're getting busy on the grill right now. We are grill side. How about that? You gotta love this time of day when you're slowing down the world and just getting ready for a little good grilled action here. So we're gonna go ahead and put our pork loins on. Got some apple smoke going. We're going to go ahead and toss those babies directly on the fire. Listen real carefully and you'll hear the sizzle.
Oh yeah.
That sounds beautiful. Listen to that sizzle. That is just music to my ears and all my senses in my head. So we got those on. We're going to turn them in 3 minutes. Get a little grill mark action going. And we're going to just grill these nice and slow, probably for about 45 minutes to an hour. We're getting busy on the grill right now. And then when we get into it, towards the end, in the last 10 to 15 minutes, we'll be putting on this raspberry glaze. Okay, these are the portobello mushrooms. Mine is in a balsamic with some Italian dressing. It has some olive oil in it. And then this one is for my wife. She likes feta cheese on hers with just olive oil. So that's what she's having. And then there is the raspberry glaze of our slow cooking Gagmeanna pork loins. And this is apple smoke we got going, so it's all good. These are about 25 minutes in. We got another 20 to 25 minutes, and then they're going to be ready for the delish taste and for the super dinner phase. Right now we are in smelting. Bing and bang, done. All right, so we're doing the delish taste now. Just cut off a little piece here. Let's see what we got here. Wow, that was so good. Fantastic. Sit down. And then my dog's gonna get a big, hey, good boy. He loves it. Now we're gonna put on the raspberry glaze. We're gonna load it on big time for these last 10 minutes. Oh my God, the smell coming off of this is like intoxicating. I can't even tell you. Smell-o-vision not in place yet. The apple smoke going with this raspberry. The bourbon coming off of it is just unbelievable. Now over here, we've got these little guys going. These are my portobellos. Now what's interesting is you take off your stems. Those are the stems of our portobellos. And your stems are almost like an appetizer. So you take the stem off and you just put them in a little bit of olive oil and balsamic, and they become just a great little kind of pre-dinner deal. And that's the deal. So we're real busy right now. So we've gotten busy, we're getting busy, we're getting busier. Apple smoke's going. Thanks for joining me. Marinate off and grill responsibly. Chop, sizzle, grill, eat. We'll talk to you next time.